will now enter the hands-on session of this course, and we will do so by means of Excel, the most powerful tool for an engineer. The reason behind using Excel to introduce energy modeling is simple. With Excel, every equation is in plain sight, easy to identify and to modify. And once the basics of the energy modeling are clear in an Excel file, it will be then just a matter of scale up to the more complex models. We will need to add a second tool to Excel to allow us solving slightly more complex problems, the Add-in Open Solver. You can download the latest stable version from the official website. Save the folder you downloaded in a safe place. Then, from Excel, go to File, Option, Add-ins, Manage, Excel Add-ins, go Browse. And browse to the folder where you just saved OpenSolver and select the file opensolver.xlam. Let's now take a look at the structure of the Excel file that has been provided to you. The first sheet, named Data, contains the parameters of the models, and the user is free to input them according to the case study. The first table contains the parameters for the power production technologies, existing capacity in the system at year zero, the availability and/or capacity factor of the technology based on availability of resources and planned downtimes, the efficiency of the different technologies, the specific investment cost in dollars per watt, the fixed O&Ms in dollars per watt year, the variable O&Ms in dollars per watt hour, and the specific land use in square meters per watt. The second table contains the cost of the fossil fuel every year. The third table, the electricity demand throughout the years. Then, the specific emissions of technologies and the discount rate are reported. In the main sheet, named Baseline, the core of the model is contained. It is possible to clearly distinguish, in blue, the decision variables, new capacity installed and energy produced. All the other cells, in white, are the intermediate variables. They will change according to the change of the decision variables. They are, for example, the total capacity that will change accordingly to the new capacity installed, the maximum production, consequence of the total capacity, the fuel consumption, consequence of the energy produced, and all the costs, investment, fixed and variable, function of new capacity installed and energy produced. In green, in the bottom part of the sheet, is the objective function, being the NPC of the project. Finally, from the data ribbon, click on Model, we can see the optimization constraints that are necessary to perform the optimization. We can see how we fix the objective cell to the one containing the objective function, asking the solver to minimize it by varying the decision variables, respecting two constraints: the energy balance, demand has to be equal to production, and the energy produced has to be lower than the maximum producible energy according to the installed power.